Senior Consultant Neurosurgeon, Apollo Hospital, Navi Mumbai. Today I will be sharing my thoughts about something which we call as minimally invasive brain surgery or minimally invasive neurosurgery. Now, before we understand minimally invasive, we will compare it to what we do conventionally. And then, conventionally speaking, neurosurgery or approach to a, say, a brain tumor involves steps including the step 1 being craniotomy or making the bony opening, bony window through which we go inside. Step 2 is creating a passage or the corridor which takes us to the tumor. Step 3 is handling of the brain tissue, which may involve some amount of retraction. And then step 4 is actual step of going ahead and removing the tumor. So, taking this one by one, craniotomy. And conventionally, when we do craniotomies, we localize the craniotomy where we are going to make the opening in the bone and at what size opening we are going to make. So, the factors which help us determine where we are going to make the opening are some external skin or other surface markings. And we know the relation with the underlying brain structures, and we do a marking or a localization based on just external appearances of the skin and the skull. So, but there in individuals there are variations, which there can be that leads to a margin of error. So, to accommodate for that margin of error, we tend to make openings bigger than what is basically required, so that if there is any underlying variation, that can be accommodated. So we make craniotomies which are larger, and once we make the larger craniotomies, we expose a larger amount of brain tissue. So more amount of brain tissue when we expose, we are subjecting brain to potentially more risk, because more exposure, more tendency to get damage. Now, when we talk about minimally invasive, what we do is we use techniques like intraoperative navigation, where we sort of tailor our craniotomies to the specific size of the tumor. So we can reduce the size of the craniotomies by using intraoperative navigation, and we can thus reduce the exposure to the normal brain tissue and thus minimizing the risk. So this is being minimally invasive. Talking about the step 2, which is the corridor or the passage. Now, when we talk about the passage, we have to, traditionally the concept of passage is we should have the shortest passage to the tumor. Why shortest passage? Because all brain tissue has got some function. So when we go through, we go through the minimum amount of brain tissue, so because minimum amount of potential risk to the tissues or the structures or the functions which lie along the corridor. Now, as we grow, as our knowledge increases and the technology improves, what we have come to realize that not all brain functions are equally divided all over the brain. Some parts are more vital than the other. What you medically call as some parts are more eloquent than the other. So using techniques like MR tectography and functional MRI, we can localize important brain functions and try and have a corridor which is safe corridor instead of the shortest corridor. The safe corridor can be a longer corridor, but it avoids injury to the vital functions. So this is another way of being minimally invasive. So we are being less invasive. The important word is that by invasion, we are causing less amount of trauma or potential risk to the normal brain tissue. So we are trying to preserve the brain tissue. Step 3 is handling the brain tissue. Now, when we handle the brain tissue, one way of handling the brain tissue is we go ahead and see the tumor is right there on the brain surface. Some tumors are there on the brain surface. So, we go ahead, it's easy for us to remove. And there are some tumors which are like the skull based tumors, which are on the other side of the brain. So we have to do some amount of retraction of the brain tissue, or we have to manipulate the brain tissue to reach that. So instead of that, we change our trajectory. So there's a partial overlap with the corridor. Like skull based tumors, we can, instead of going through a craniotomy, we can go through the nose. We do what is called transnasal endoscopic extended skull based surgeries. So instead of going around the tumor or going through the brain tissue with minimal retraction or no retraction, we change the corridor where the brain handling is not required at all possible. And other way of minimizing the handling of the brain tissue is doing what you call as retractor. Normally when we do surgery, we use brain retractors to retract the brain. So now is what we have changed, the concept has changed from using fixed brain retractors to dynamic brain retraction. So we are moving from a retractor based surgery to a retractor less surgery. So that is again being minimally invasive. The step 4, which is the last step and the most critical step, is removal of the tumor. Now, as far as the removal of the tumor is concerned, conventionally when we see the tumor, we tend to create an interface or a plane between the tumor and the adjacent normal brain. And in this process, there is some handling of the brain tissue which is involved. And the people may, in their enthusiasm, try to remove either the tumor in toto or in large chunks. So it's something like exploding the tumor. So once there is an explosion, there is a damage to the adjacent structures. So when we do this type of a dissection, creating plane between the tumor and the surrounding brain, so there is handling of the brain and there is potential risk of brain damage happening, which is much more. So how can we be minimally invasive in that? The way to be minimally invasive in that is we use things like CUSA, which is continuous ultrasonic aspirator. This is a device which uses sound waves and breaks the tumor millimeter by millimeter. And thus we enter the tumor from one of its surfaces, remove the tumor piecemeal by millimeter, and tend to sort of eat away the tumor from inside. And once we leave just a thin shell of the outer capsule of the tumor, and we empty the tumor from inside, and once the tumor is emptied from inside, then it sort of caves in, or it falls in, or as you call it, it implodes. So once it caves in, then it's easy to dissect off the remaining part of the tumor with practically minimal handling of the adjacent brain tissue. Thus, less handling, less risk, that's being minimally invasive. So to sum it up, if we talk about minimally invasive surgery, it involves not only making a smaller opening, it also involves choosing a corridor which is the safest. It also involves minimizing the use of brain retractors, and at the same time it also involves imploding the tumor rather than exploding the tumor. Thank you.